I'm here at the Fighting Connection Gym, one of the best gyms in Southern California. Who's here? Who runs the gym? None other than former world champion, Layman Brewster. And of course, the address of this gym, you should stop by, 11912 Mississippi, not far from Bundy Street and from Olympic Avenue. So I have to ask you this, Layman, as a former heavyweight champion, you fought the best. What do you say? David Hay says he's not going to renew his boxing license.
I think that what he may be doing is just taking some time off to do some soul searching. He's not really, he knows in his heart he don't really want to retire, because I think it's hard to kind of go out on a sour note, especially being that he's still got his youth on his side. He's a good fighter. He's had a good taste of what it's like to have the fame and the money. So I think he's just doing a little soul searching, man. I think he's going to come back, but I think it's going to be what I think any smart fighter would do is going to be selective fights to build up, not just his confidence, but to get the ring rust back off. And I think he's going to be all right, man.
Okay, him against Areola, him against James Toney, him against Vitaly. How do you see those if he decides not to retire?
You know, something, it's hard to say, man, because I really don't know what he's really capable of, because he beat the one person in the world that I really had a lot of respect for in boxing, which was Mormack. And I didn't think that he would be able to beat Mormack, but he did, and it really impressed me, because Mormack, he reminds me of like a modern-day Marvin Hagler, you know. He's a beast, man. And the fact that he beat him, it really got my respect. And then to watch his fights with fighters like John Ruiz, you know, which John Ruiz is he's the type of fighter that'll frustrate the heck out of you, but the way he was able to handle him, it really got my respect. So, you know, I support him really in whatever it is that he does, man, as long as he keeps it positive, as long as he comes back and give 100%. But if he decides to retire at the same time as a cruiserweight, he paid his dues, you got to respect that, and I do.
You're a former heavyweight. Eddie Sanchez is a former heavyweight.
Ugly weight. He's an ugly weight. That's a new division.
I was actually a junior middleweight, not heavyweight. Layman makes
but
me
you
look
sparred.
Big.
You sparred the Klitschko's.
Well, you know, just for speed, not just to actually go in there and...
So why didn't they spar Pacquiao?
I don't know. Maybe it was below his knee. Who knows?
But what do you say about David Hay's retirement?
You know what? I agree with Layman. I don't think he's done. He just need to clear his head a little bit. You know, it's a lot of stuff riding on him, especially when he made the big publicity stunt with fighting Klitschko.
His toe hurt.
Oh, you know, my hand when I broke my hurt when I broke my hand, and I still kept fighting with a broken hand 7 more rounds.
Well, he had to sell himself, though. You know, at the end of the day, you still gotta sell yourself, and yeah, he talked a big talk, but guess what? That made him rich. You know what I mean? So as a businessman, I thought he did a great job of going out there making people believe that he could pull it off, and a lot of people did believe because they spent the money for that fight. So I can't be mad at him, and you know, at the end of the day, because he gets to eat, you know, he gets to provide for his family. You know, I don't feel like he necessarily misled people. I think he went out there and he did the best that he could, regardless of his toe or not. I think that what he realized when he was out there was that he could not beat Vladimir at boxing, and he didn't have a B plan, because B plan would have been to abandon trying to box and maybe try to force Vladimir into a
fight. You know what he should have done, Layman? He should have picked up the phone, called the Fighting Connection, said, hey, Layman, you fought Vladimir, you beat him, how did you do it? Can I take something from you? The fighters sometimes do that, when they call you and they ask you, can we have some pages from your book? How you fight
too
someone?
Too much pride, too much ego, because it steps on the pride and ego of a trainer. And Dion! Hey, D! Hey, D! Hey, keep it down just a little bit, please. Okay. Thanks. That's my brother, Dion Brewster. The man with the green face. Everybody said the poison Klitschko.
I agree. You poison Klitschko.
Oh, thanks, Ugly. I mean, Eddie.
I agree.
No, I forgot what I was saying.
You were saying people have too much pride to pick up the phone.
Yes.
But if I'm about to fight a guy that you beat, I would ask you, I mean, if it was a very close fight, what were the little things you did? Nothing wrong with that. So I was just,
your trainer would have a problem, because then it would go against all the years he spent training that, he's not a wise enough trainer that he got to go and ask a guy who fought another guy to help him to win. You know what I mean? So again, you know, ego, it says in the Bible, pride is the downfall of man. So that's what it is.
Eli, you know how jealous the trainers get? Perfect example, it just happened to me a week ago. You know, we were up at the training camp. You saw me working with Mago and the heavyweights, and the trainer just felt like, oh man, this guy is doing something that I'm not doing, or my fighter is liking him more. And I told him I wasn't there to take anybody's job. I was just there to help as an assistant. And luckily I had what Mago needed for what he needed for that fight. And I provided from those tools and we ended up winning again. Now he's standing out with 10 knockouts. But like Lehman was saying, trainers, they don't know how to work. They get too over the head. They don't want to be open mind. For example, if I'm doing something wrong and I don't see it, if Layman sees me or Dion sees me or another trainer sees me, hey, why don't you do this? I go, wow, I didn't see that. Okay. That's what makes somebody a great trainer, somebody who's willing to listen from all different angles and see what's going on around them.
It never hurts to have another pair of eyes. So there you have it from the Fighting Connection Gym in West Los Angeles, 11912 Mississippi Avenue, not far from the strip club next door, not far from Bundy, and not far from Olympic. BeastNewsReporting.com. I'm Melly Stickback reporting.